For some YouTubers, the standard video format just isn't enough. Creators like MrBeast and Mark Rober have uncovered a new YouTube success formula, and it's working. Thanks to this format, they're growing fast and consistently averaging tens of millions of views per video. Don't be mistaken, these two didn't get to where they are now by accident. They're some of the only creators consistently pulling this many views, so what is the difference between them and other experienced YouTubers? After analyzing videos from both their channels, I started to recognize a few patterns. Both Jimmy and Mark posted videos with one surprising quirk. They both delivered the thumbnail and title's promise at the beginning of the video. This struck me as odd, because from all the channel data I've seen, viewership usually dips after the payoff the video promised was revealed. How are they keeping viewers engaged and getting more views than ever before? Once I dove deeper, I saw they were both using the exact same three-part system for virality I'm calling the Rebait Method, and I'll be covering each part throughout this video. Let's examine what they're up to together by studying MrBeast's latest video. I'll be walking you through his video and showing you the format in action. But before we do that, let's go over the most important success variable. Moving on to the first part, finding the right viral topic. MrBeast is really good at this. Here's proof. In 2019, YouTuber Veritasium was talking to him about an upcoming video and showed him some of the footage. Jimmy took one look at this image and said in response,
"That's a banger."
Sure enough, that video received billions of impressions and is still Veritasium's biggest video yet. Creators like Jimmy can think of 100 video ideas and easily recognize the one that's most likely to blow up. Now, this part of their format isn't new, but it's an absolutely vital first step. Before Jimmy or Mark even start recording, they make sure their concept follows these four simple steps. The first thing is finding a specific concept. This video is titled, "Would You Sit in Snakes for $10,000?" Though that's not all that happens. Really, it's just a video of random challenges for large amounts of money, but there's a reason it's not titled "People Do Challenges for Money." For a YouTube title, don't be vague. Try to explore a specific idea you have in mind. The next aspect involves the target audience. Even though the concept is narrowed down to something very specific, videos following the Rebait format prioritize mass appeal. We'll go into more detail on that later in the video. Third, these videos tend to have extreme stakes. They're simple concepts with large commitments. Usually for MrBeast, that means challenges that take a long time or have a lot of money on the line. He wins the click when you think to yourself, there's no way he actually did that. Once the perfect concept has been decided on, finding the most clickable thumbnail and title combination is key. This is so important because, like a wise man once said,
if people don't click, they don't watch, so you want to give them something to click.
For the title, I suggest writing out many variations until you find one that's strong enough. That Mark Rober video I mentioned earlier? Well, I've been keeping track, and so far he's tested four different title variations and at least three different thumbnails. Finding the best thumbnail title combo requires iteration, whether that's before you upload or sometimes after. Why are thumbnails so important? You could, and probably have, spend hours, days, or weeks working on a video that's so perfect it has to go viral. You finally get it done, and in the excitement of wanting to show the world your masterpiece, you quickly patch together a mediocre thumbnail and race to the upload button. You sit there nervously refreshing, waiting for the millions of views to pour in, and that was an excerpt from Jay Alto, a bona fide thumbnail expert, from his incredible thumbnail guide. This guy really knows what he's doing, and several of the concepts I'm about to talk about I learned through him. I highly recommend reading his full guide down below, first link in the description. Generally, successful videos are presented to potential viewers in these three places: the homepage, suggested sidebar, or search results. All three of these places are extremely competitive, and YouTube won't push your video unless people are clicking on it often enough. As Jay describes, the process works like this. The thumbnail gets the viewer's attention and creates enough curiosity to want to learn more. They read the title and it confirms their curiosity and adds to it. And finally, the viewer either clicks on the video or moves on. The image itself should communicate what makes your video unique. MrBeast will often break the norm and show you something you've never seen before. His most viewed video has a simple thumbnail, but it's so crazy that it's hard to ignore. Looking into MrBeast's recent uploads, you can see they all follow these four steps. But next, we'll talk about what really makes this new format effective. Moving on to the second part, having segmented videos. When watch time is everything to the YouTube algorithm, it seems counterintuitive to deliver what the video promised right away. So why does he do it? The typical YouTube video follows this standard format. There's an interesting hook that explains why you should watch it, a lead up to the height of the video, the payoff at the end, and then the video is over. The problem is in the lead up, where viewers are the most likely to get bored of the idea or see something more interesting and they're recommended. Here, Mr. Beast does something different.
But since you said no, you just won $100,000. Here's $20,000.
When someone clicks on this video, they expect to see someone be offered $100,000 to quit school, and they get exactly that within the first 45 seconds of the video. At this point, there's still 10 minutes left, and you realize there must be a lot more to this video than the title suggested. This is an 11-part video, Viral Ideas Inside a Viral Idea, increasing the chances of success. MrBeast himself has said on many occasions that his standard for a new video has never stopped getting higher. He's catering to his returning viewers who have already seen him give away money. Why not raise the bar and do it 7 more times? What's really interesting is that each section has stakes as high as the last. The end of one challenge is the start of another, and you get rebaited into watching more. You're pulled through each clip with no breaks and no chances to leave without missing something. Cuts are quick and clips are short, especially in the intro. The first segment of this video has 42 cuts, each clip lasting an average of 1.3 seconds. MrBeast knows that fast-paced editing keeps the momentum going, with no dead space allowing viewers time to get distracted. But what he does next is a subtle but important technique to keep viewers engaged.
This is gonna be a while, so we'll find out later in the video if she wins the Lambo. I have over-
With a Lamborghini on the line, he moves on to the next challenge, leaving you wondering if she can win it. In total, he cuts to the Lambo challenge 4 times, and doesn't reveal the result until the 4th time, and by then the video's over. Videos following this format over-deliver and exceed expectations, but there's still something missing. Moving on to the next part, appealing to a general audience. To get the highest view counts, it makes sense to target the biggest audience, everyone. Who your target audience is can change between channels and individual videos, but rebate videos optimize for all demographics. They try to appeal to your emotions, making you feel curiosity, shock, or disbelief. MrBeast's preferred method to accomplish this is with challenges involving money. They're simple to understand, not the type of videos you want to take notes on. A more technical video won't appeal to everyone, which explains why the format of this video doesn't match exactly. Though, if you were to watch it again, you may notice me employing a few of the tactics I mentioned. If you found this video interesting, let me know down below. If you want to watch another, YouTube thinks you'll like this one the most.